Good morning, freshies. My name's Serge Nokise. This is the Bro Matariki. The sun is coming up and the breakfast jams are kicking off here in Guam at the 12th Annual Festival of Pacific Arts.
Now, I'm still buzzing out that we got to fly over on the Royal New Zealand Air Force's Bro Force One. Woo. And we get to hang out with 2,500 other artists from 27 different islands around the Pacific. I mean, I've never seen so many beautiful people in one place.
That's because you've got to get out of Auckland more, bro. True story. Hey, here's what's coming up next on the show.
Starting out, I got heckled by a dude in the late show. I didn't have a comeback and I panicked, so I just took off my jandal, threw it in his face.
Oh, what?
Did you have sex yet?
No, not in my school. Is it all boys' school? You're a girl.
Oh, what up, fishies? This has got to be some of the best raw fish I've ever tried. It's got fish calaguin and it's from right here in Guam. Now, I'm going to eat them up. But old James, he's somewhere in this festival roaming around, showing you what's up.
Excuse me, can I please talk to you for a minute? Take a minute, girl, to punch it down. What's been happening? What's been happening?
Hey, it's Jeff Nokise here at the Pacific Arts Festival. There's a whole lot going on here. Real buzz around, confused tourists who don't know who the hell I am or what I'm doing. Let's go check out what's going on. Coconut crab?
Yes. In tomorrow, we call it a zuzu. But how you say that? We're gonna have it for dinner?
Speechless. Well, fair enough. What are you doing in Guam, my friend?
You jerked the chicken.
You jerked the chicken?
And the ribs.
You jerked the chicken and the ribs? That's your official job title?
Yes.
We're from New Caledonia and like back at home, we speak French. It's really hard, eh? To speak with other people, but we just share what we got, eh?
Can you say keeping it fresh in French?
Vas-y man, molo.
People always ask me where the best comedy comes from, and I always say the kitchen. So let's go check out the kitchen area here at FestPAC 2016. Full screen HD, let me take another picture, let me pull it to the pre-show. Whoa, cool beans, that's a... So you do coconut...
Sashimi, that's with soy sauce and wasabi.
How does that work? Because my instincts go no.
You would say no because you're a first-time trier. Once you're done drinking it, then I cut it open for you. I'll scrape the meat out and I'll put soy sauce and wasabi, which is pre-made. Put the lime in the coconut,
she drank and pulled up, she put the lime. That was a lot of coconut. That was one chop, in case you weren't paying attention.
Thank you very much.
To the undiscerning eye, it looks like I've just been sick in my coconut. But in fact, this is a delicacy. This is delicious.
Keep it fresh from loving Guam.
We are in the back of Capital Kitchen with...
Casey.
Alfredo Ray.
What are you making here?
This is our finger steak with island red rice, dyed with chote seed to give it that red color. It's a big thing here in Guam.
What's the craziest stuff you guys have seen at the festival so far?
Just being able to see all the cultures from people from all over the world, just like showcasing their art. Sometimes they would be out here right in front of our booths, singing, dancing.
What's the freshest food you sell here?
Basically, all our food is fresh.
So when we're saying what's fresh, we're asking like, what's good? What's the Guam version of that word? Like something that's dope?
Cherry, solid, muddy.
Muddy, what's muddy mean, man?
It's just muddy, you know?
So if I see some of the performers on stage and I'm like, yeah, they're totally muddy.
Yeah, there you go, brother. Keep it fresh and keep it muddy, only in Guam, baby.
Fried fish, breadfruit, and coleslaw. This is a chamorro invention, pretty much. Onions, hot pepper, vinegar, and soy sauce.
Off a day from Guam, FestPAC 2016, keep it fresh.
We're on Guam here at Pacific Island Mangi Pod.
This, if you're wondering, New Zealand, tastes as good as a topper.
Amazing.
freshies, a coconut star with fish for the main course, and a beautiful organic ice block for dessert. This is James Nokise, keeping it fresh. This festival happens only once every 4 years, so don't miss out on this Olympic-level freshness.
How fresh, though?
This festival is so fresh, you could put it in a can and drink it to refresh yourself.
Ooh, I'll have one.
No, no can for you.
Oh. Well, here's what's coming up next. What is the biggest, most epic fail you've ever had on stage?
Biggest fail is Party Haka Festival, 5,000 people at a festival of peace, singing the song, Na Na Na, Hey Hey, Goodbye.
Happy birthday, Kazzy.
Thanks,
mate. Hmm. How old are you? Did you hoe the garden for the kumara?
Yeah, I did. Then I got tired.
Kaz, you're supposed to hoe water garden.
Hoe water stink breath.
Welcome back to Fresh. Now, Matariki's brought me here to Two Lovers Point, and I have no idea why, bro.
Man, what better place to get to know you? This elusive dude, I've been following his career for a long time. I even lived in the same city as him for 6 years, went to the same uni, pretty much.
Oh, that's not creepy.
Nah, not at all. But hey, you guys don't have to wait as long. Here we are, with the real James Nokise and...
My time... Oh, sorry, that's 90s, ain't it? My world. Don't.
New Zealand's favorite Welsh Samoan and possible love child of Lionel Richie, James Nokise.
Good evening, guys. Yes, I'm looking a little bit different. I tried to bring a bit of Johnny Depp tonight. I am aware it has turned out Latino Nickelback.
I'm going to ask you a couple of quick five questions so we get warmed into it. First up, Batman or Thor?
Batman, I can't say my THs, so I just be standing there going, I am Thor.
No magic hammers.
That's right, bro. I got my magic hammers. Let's move on.
What did your mum used to call you as a kid, like nickname?
Okay, so my mum's from Wales. I need to point that out. She used to call me Poppet. All right. I don't know what that means, but like I like to think it's like, yeah, like a Poppet, right? Like maybe my mum was ahead of her time.
Now, just to explain my accent, because if you've noticed already, I don't have your typical New Zealand accent. Like I said, my father was from Samoa, and my mother is from Wales. They met in Papua New Guinea, where they fell in love, which was great for them and terrible for my mother's husband. But others, a beautiful Pacific relationship. That's why my accent sounds a bit like it.
What's your tips on tying a year lava lava?
I call this the phallic style. It's very simple. You get your basic lava lava, you twist, you tuck, and you overpromise.
For the kids out there, phallic is just it's a beautiful flower. What is the freshest moment in stand-up comedy that you've ever had?
So when I was starting out, I got heckled by a dude in a late show. I didn't have a comeback and I panicked, so I just took off my jandal, threw it in his face.
Oh, what, really?
Yeah.
Someone? Was he a Samoan guy?
No, it's a Palangi guy. I wouldn't throw it to Samoan.
Yeah, okay. Because
he might catch it and throw it back.
Yeah.
It's not a cliche, it's a skill.
I've seen it happen.
Yeah.
I might get a shole with it as well.
The trick, young Ricky, always aim with the blade. Also, with the wrist, snap. Don't go for him. You'll bounce off and back into your face. Caress the jando as it leaves your hand. Just boom. See how the camera shot? That's because I just skimmed it. That's skill.
So what is the biggest, most epic fail you've ever had on stage?
Biggest fail is Party Haka Festival, 5,000 people. I was really excited because I was opening for Herbs and their comeback gig. Problem is, I thought I was doing 10 minutes, like just before midnight.
Yep.
And Herbs took like 40 minutes to get ready at that stage of my career.
You didn't have that material?
Hey, 40 minutes at midnight after Fat Freddy's drop before Herbs. And I had 5,000 people at a festival of peace hating me, singing the song, Na Na Na, Hey Hey, Goodbye. Good. In harmony too, just to wind it up.
I'm a performer too, so I get what you... Well, I don't. I'm not 5,000 people booing me. You're someone who's going to want to push some boundaries, right? You ever been hit up for it?
Yeah, man, you know what? When you're a mixed race Samoan kid, born in New Zealand, talking about Pacific culture, about cliches, about race in New Zealand, about gangs, about politics, going to be someone from anywhere coming at you.
You guys, honestly, you want to know what's tough? Stabbing people and robbing people is not tough. This is New Zealand. I have a friend who was a gay opera singer that grew up in the Manawatu. That is tough.
That's as tough as it gets in this country.
Right now, I guarantee there'll be someone who's like on the Facebook page of Fresh, who's going, "Why are you interviewing James Nokise? Pretty sure he's sunburned anyway. Not a real Samoan. He's right. Not funny." What about you, bro? You know, when you're doing your stuff, you ever get haters?
It's fine. You just log off Facebook and it's gone.
Sing in harmony.
Stop singing flat.
Yeah, play some U2.
Play some Fleetwood Mac. Is there anyone who's safe from James Nokise? You've been taking shots at the mob.
No, you can't. Like, you gotta hit everybody. Otherwise, it's not fair.
Yep.
Like. Okay, no. Okay, there's one. I don't make fun of Maori or Pacific Island women.
I don't, no, because I respect them. And also, Pacific Island women are world champions at throwing small, heavy objects. You know, shot put, discus, kids, they will get you, man.
Okay, so we won't be seeing you spar with these next two. So we've got the fierce and funny Lanita and Miss Kahiriri Nui here with their fresh tips and tricks.
Tips for the marae. If you've never been before, here are some things that you need to think about. Like, what to wear.
Oh, don't get me started. When you go to the marae, cover your flesh.
That's right.
First, foremost.
No nightclub outfits. You can't come straight from nightclub to marae. Inappropriate. Them bricks is way too high,
you need to cut it. That's it. Which means, you know, don't show us your diamond. Show 'em bright like a diamond.
Leave the diamonds at the club. Leave the diamonds at the club. Keep it safe. Keep it black.
Keep it simple. Yeah. Wear a skirt, you know, so that you're covering the sacred part of the diamond.
Jeez.
Bring a blanket. If you haven't got a skirt,
bring a blanket.
If you haven't got a blanket or a skirt, get your hot hoodie. Turn it backwards.
Yeah.
Tie it at the back. Get the hoodie, the jersey, tie it at the back.
Yeah.
And so that the front of the hoodie and then
acts a little bit like a skirt.
Because what you're doing is you're showing that respect.
Yeah.
It's not all about looking cool. Hey, mind looking cool. You're right. We're here for the dead. We're not going there to hook up. Hey, not good. Hey, don't think you go to the marae to hook up. That's not a good story, are
you? Well, let's be honest, you're probably related to most people there anyway.
I know, that's how you got here anyway. Yeah. How's your tupanae? How's your cousins? But that's all right. What we're saying is that, you know, when you're at the tangi, don't wear your summer shorts with your fringe jean denim looking shorts showing your puha and your pork bone. Not good.
Can schools should provide better sex education?
Just getting the message across better than don't do it at all. We say don't eat that. You'll probably want to eat that.
Children everywhere.
Crown.
Crown.
Hey, bro. Got a delivery for you.
Oh, yeah, just put it on the crown. Oh, I said put it on the crown? Do you know what a crown is? Is that a crown? Excuse me? Hey, show me the video on the crown.
Welcome back to the Pacific Arts Festival, when things are really starting to kick off.
What do we got next? We got Auntie Tyler throwing out some wisdom.
Keep it fresh!
Bulavinaka, and welcome back to our Tau Tala Tala Show. And we've got an amazing panel, I mean, amazing! Starting off with my favourite actress, being your senior on magazine, TV, everything. Please give it up for Frankie Adams! Yeah! And next to her, we have a producer, writer, everything, but the biggest movie role he ever had was Captain Fury of the Avengers! Oscar Conley! Wow! And we can never forget my favourite athlete, Blaine Silverfern, now a New Zealand warrior. Please give it up for Kat Triaviti! Yee-hee! Wow! coming on our show today. So let's go over to our next video message.
Hi, Auntie Tala. I just got a question. I don't want to be rude, but do you reckon schools should provide better sex education?
Wow, I think that's a very important question, Well, I guess we can start with you, Frankie. What do you think about that question?
I think that there does... I went through sex ed at school.
Yeah?
So this... But I went to an all-girls school, so maybe it's different for co-ed. It was good. It teaches you a lot, but I think there definitely isn't enough in all the schools.
Wow.
Not sure. Did you have sex ed?
No, not in my school.
Why not?
Yeah, because... It was an all boys school and we had no.
But you're a girl.
Now, what about you, Oscar, as an older gentleman?
Yes.
In your time in school, did you go through this type of course in your school?
Yeah, I remember being young ages ago, and like there was a Samoan film came on called Sons for the Return Home, and it came on TV, and we were all allowed to watch it because it was a Samoan film. But then they started having sex, and then we had to go to sleep. Just at the kissing part, and I'd like to think, I'm not going to be like that. If that happens, I'm going to stop the TV and say, okay, kids, here's a PowerPoint presentation. Here are some of the issues you need to be aware of. But chances are, I'll probably do the same and just make them go to sleep.
Yeah.
And just trust that their friends will teach them as they grow up.
Yeah, but I think it's very important to come from home too.
Yeah.
You know, what about you, Kate? When you have a children and something like that where the girl is kissing a boy on the TV, are you going to turn off and do the prayer or the church or put them to sleep? Or close, block their eyes? What are you going to do? Throw the TV around?
Yeah, probably that last one. But I think it's been spread around anyway, whether we teach it or not. Somebody else's parents are telling their kids and then they're going to school and telling everyone else. So it's getting around. I guess it's the message we want to send.
Yeah.
Don't have sex or do it properly or the repercussions of having kids really early. Like, just getting the message across better than don't do it at all. Because very rebellious, like yourself, if we say don't eat that, you'll probably want to eat that. Naughty.
Them children everywhere. Yeah. Well, I guess, Kat, what can you say to Amanda about what she asked?
Well, Amanda, who you actually look like a Maxine, but whatever, Amanda will do. You might have benefited from a little sex education, I can tell by that little rugrat you're carried around. But yeah, we do need more education, but we need to direct it properly into doing it properly and not doing it at all. So that's what I think.
Wow.
Yeah,
thank you for that, Jay. I like your approach, just straight up.
Oh, thank you.
Just like how you play rugby.
Straight shooter.
Yeah, the way she runs up the board. Anyway, what about for you, Oscar? What can you say to Amanda to help her with this CYN?
Well, I think, Amanda, it's great that you're asking this and that if that is your child, then, you know, maybe as a parent and your child's at school, you can, you know, be more proactive about the kind of education your kid's exposed to. Mm. So I think just good on you for asking these questions and all the best with the young one.
Yeah, good. I think you make a great father.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Thanks.
Well, you're going to find out soon. Okay, you are. Frankie, what would you like to say to help out Amanda?
Hi, Amanda. I don't think that there's enough sex education, but maybe they should find more creative ways to do it, like still life.
Still life.
Yeah. Maybe that.
Yeah. I think Frankie still needs some sex education herself. Well, obviously, you needed some sex education because you were young and you had a young baby as well. Not like me. I had no sex education. Well, I had no sex at all. Anyway, so you can help just by sharing your experience together with what's happening at school, and that will make everyone a lot more sexier. So hope to see you on our program again, but not with another baby. Okay, see you next week, same time, same place. Bye!
We're having a great time here in Guam, and the most beautiful thing are the Chamorro people.
Yeah, man, I almost feel embarrassed. I didn't know much about Guam or the Chamorro culture before I came over.
Right.
Like, when I told my boys I was coming, they were like, hey, awesome, brother. Where's Guam?
Well, if you don't know, now you know. Here's a Poly postcard with our mate, Takota.
Off a day. My name is Dakota Alcantara Komatsu, and I come from this place, Guam. I'm actually standing on my family's land right now. My grandpa grew up here in the 20s, grew up fishing here, and this is Hagatnya. The freshest things about Guam, well, first of all, would be Guam, which is the original name for this place. It means the place of existence, which is what the Maktou, the indigenous people, call it. The second thing, our arts movement right now. The third one would be the amazing food that we make. The secret sauce is called Pinadeni. Cool, so we're here at the Lemai Cafe. It's a historic site here and one of the best restaurants to eat on island. It's local food. It's the recipes come from our manana, from our ancestors. Come inside. Is anybody really out there? This is Pinadeni, and it is the most important secret in the entire world. It makes everything taste better. This is tanaktak. It is the Chamorro specialty. It's coconut milk and beef. You have to be careful with this one because it can knock you out. This is the Tao. It's the guardian spirit of my chant family. And it's also in the shape of a lati, which are the stone pillars that hold up our ancestral homes. Below our lati are the bones of our ancestors. My friends and my cousins and I, whenever we're in the area, we'll stop here at this site just to show respect to our ancestors, to do a little ceremony. That's my Pali postcard from Guam.
That's it, fam. We out.
But fear not, you got Maisie Rika and an all-star cast showing you around the rest of the festival next week.
Here's a little taste of what's coming up.
Okay, see you later.
Bye.
Kia ora, freshies. It's Macy here. I'm here at the 12th Pacific Arts Festival here in Guam. All the islands are here to celebrate in their art, music, and food. We'll see you then. Ka kite.